Woo! Welcome to Kratos BI. I'm the Power BI Luchador, and today we're going to be talking about premium per user licensing, or PPU. Before we head on over to that, me and you, we're going to have a little talk about hitting that like button, subscribing to the channel, and turning on the alerts, because if you want to get all the fire and all the energy and all the power that you can bring into your Power BI environment, and you want to catch up on every single Power BI Luchador video, you don't want to miss any of them, make sure you hit all those buttons down below. All right, let's head over to it. Okay, so Ignite was a big week. This week, we had a big announcement from Mr. Christopher Finland. He's the champion on the Power BI team. He's a principal program manager who's out there helping us deliver this content, make sure that we get this brand new licensing model. You've asked for it for a long time. There's lots of features inside of Power BI Premium that, straight up, if you didn't have $5,000 a month, you know, to be able to spend on Premium, you couldn't do it. You were straight out left out in the cold. So what were you to do? This is what you're here to do. All right, this Power BI Premium per user licensing, what it allows you to do is it allows you to take advantage of all these additional features when it comes to working inside of Power BI. Larger models, that means you're no longer capped at that just 10 gigabytes. You get to go up to 100 gigabytes of data that you get to store in your model. You get to up your refresh rates. You get to do all sorts of paginated reports, AI builder, the whole kit and caboodle you get inside of your Power BI Premium space. And that's just by using your Premium per user licensing model. An incredibly new, great new feature that you're just straight up going to love and be able to use across your organizations. Especially, oh my gosh, how can I even forget the data pipelines? Holy cow, this has been something that's been reserved to just premium users or beyond just premium users, but premium instances that had that allowed you to have dev, QA, and production environments all inside of premium. That's really expensive, except for, especially when you're talking about potentially really crappy, poor performing development and stuff. You don't want to necessarily do that inside of your production premium environment. This model is going to allow your engineers and your developers who are working on your large enterprise models that go out and are hosted in premium to be able to take advantage of those lower environment premium features, be able to use those pipelines to migrate that up and then go into that full-on premium for sharing. That's just one of the models here. You can use premium for sharing paginated reports out to like 10 users or to having an AI builder go out for 100 people. It's super exciting. We're really excited to see more about this. I'm going to put the links down below so you can check it out. But the big question, the number one question I get, you guys are all asking for it. What's it going to cost? How much is it going to be? We just don't know. I mean, there's been some leaks. Some people have said some things. I don't know. I put together a little something for you so you could go on and check out what the price of the Power BI Premium could be. All right. They've already said it's going to be an additional cost, right? So I did a little breakout here that I'm going to share with you now. So let's check this guy out. All right. So this would be your break-even point if you're looking at, you know, P1s, P2s, or P3s when you're needing capacity. If we're talking $10 a month, that's the Power BI price. They've already said Power BI Premium, it ain't going to be this guy, right? So we're not talking 500 users in a P1 or 1,000 in a P2 or 2,000 P3. So it's not going to be that $10 a month. Let's say it's at your $20 a month price point, which seems reasonable, right? Like, you know, we have 10 for basic, 20 for premium, keeps it simple, keeps it cheap, keeps it affordable. That means if you're under 250 users inside your organization, you want to take advantage of these great features, totally, you can do it. Now, if you're going to take a step up to, let's say they go to a $30 a month. So it's $30 a month for licensing for a user. What's my break-even point here? Now, if it's only $30 a month, your break-even point's 167 users, right, for a P1. That means if you're under 167, you should be looking at the PPU licensing model to be able to bring this functionality to your company if it's released at $30. Now, what I've done, You ask Chris, hey, where did you get these price points? What I did is I took the price points of common competitors of Microsoft for Power BI when we looked at their monthly user costs, right? So I have a couple of those that I'm going to share for you and give you a rundown. So there's the $30 competitor price. Then there's also the $80 competitor price because there's competitors that are $80 a month per user. In that case, we're talking just 63 users makes going to a P1. That's your cutoff. That's when you go to the P1. If it's less than 63, hey, $80 a month is great. I'm not gonna name the competitor, but there's even one competitor out there that's $100 a user a month. If that's the case, all it takes is 50 users to get you into that actual premium capacity. I'm gonna guess though. I'm gonna bet it's not gonna be 100. It's not gonna be 30. I don't think it's gonna be 30. We know it's not going to be 10. That leaves us with only one place to go. I'm calling it now. I'm predicting the future. I'm saying it's going to be $20. I don't know. I'm guessing that this is the price point it's going to be. What else could it be? It's not going to be 10. It could be 30. But you know who gives you value? You know who delivers value every day? Microsoft delivers you value all the time, right? So it's not going to be that $30 price point. There's no way it's going to be 80. No way it's going to be 100. All right, maybe it's 30, maybe it's 20. My bet's on $20. I'm not taking actual bets because Power BI Luchador only bets in wrestling matches. So if you're up for it, if you're down for it, comment down below. We'll get a wrestling match on if it's anything other than $20 a month. But I think this is a price point that we're going to see when we go live. All right. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Power BI Luchador out at KratosBI.com. I think that lightweight's going to be back next time when it comes to doing these videos. He's got some things up on his board here about like Power BI high availability, AAS replication, all sorts of different things like surrogate keys. I don't even know what that is. I'm interested to find out about surrogate keys. Thank you very much. Again, if you like the content, hit like, subscribe, turn on that alarm bell. Heck, head over to KratosBI.com. Buy him a coffee and he'll send you one of these like classic magical Power BI stickers with that old logo. Did you see the new icon? What the heck? This is the new icon, just in case you didn't know. This is the new one. Thoughts? I don't know. But thank you very much. Peace.